Okay, here's update 6. What a great deal to update, actually. If you look in, some people look at these on YouTube account, and they'll be wondering where update 5's gone. It's because I didn't do a video update last time, because I couldn't be asked. So anyway, this is update 6. I'm now back, as you can see, from my house. I went to see Whiskey for a week. Spent a week up there. It rained every day. I arrived in snow. And we had the storm a bit. So the weather wasn't that good. But it was nice just to get up there and see. So I'm back now. This might look a bit jumpy because I've just added this bit. So I wanted to get it down. When I got back from Wales, I had a couple of things to sort out. Carl was one of them. I had it a few months, and I got a recall on it. Something to do with the back end drops down and can rub on the brake pipes. So anyway, I had to come back and get that sorted out. So done that. Plus, I needed to get my wheel finalised to make sure that the person and people that I wanted to have what I have got, which I haven't got. I wanted to make sure they got it legally, so I got that done. I've got family, but I've not seen my two kids from my ex-marriage. In about 27 years, they've not been in touch. I've tried to get in touch, but got them back on the part of the divorce settlement. So they won't be getting nothing. And I've got another daughter from a beautiful girl I went out with for a couple of years. Beautiful girl, but she was a complete fucking psycho. Scottish girl. And she eventually took off and went up to Scotland somewhere. Took my daughter with her. So I've not seen her and I've no idea where she is. Not seen her away from her, which is sad. And then I've got a stepsister and a stepbrother. Stepbrother I've not heard from for ages. A few weeks ago I got an email saying, I've not heard from you for a while. Well, pick the fucking phone up, you cunt. Well, you're upset because we did mum's ashes. Now, my mum died in May. And apparently, my stepsister, she's a bit... pushy at times. She wanted to, she phoned me one day in November when I was up in Wales and said, oh, we ought to do mum's ashes. And I said, well, I can't wait till I get back. Bearing in mind my mum died in May and this is now November, so 5-6 months later, and she's wanting to get the ashes done, which were in an urn on a shelf in his stepbrother's garage, so it's not like they were taking up room or in the way and people tripping over them and sweeping them up every so often. So anyway, they couldn't do that because it didn't suit his stepbrother. And then I found out while I was having an angiogram in Bedford, found out a couple of days later, she phoned up.
How you doing?
Oh, we done mum's ashes. So they scattered her ashes where my mum wanted. So I never got the chance to see the final resting place for my mum's ashes. I'm not a religious person, but it would have been nice to have been there, seeing as it was my mum. So anyway, fuck them, they're getting nothing. So that's basically it. Yep. So, needed to get the wheel done and a few odds and ends sorted out. So I've done that now. We'll crack on with what's what. Still no change on the date, so as far as I know it's the 24th still. Not so here any different. And that's basically it for an update. But somebody, a mate of mine, I was talking to him on the phone the other day. And he said to me, what's it like having cancer? So I don't mean mentally, he said obviously it fucks your head probably. He said, but physically, do you know you got it? Is it like you get a cold and you get a runny nose or some symptom? So I said, yeah, that's a good question. I got diagnosed last year, September, but I knew before that I probably had it, because for a lot of last year I was shitting blood, not all the time, but and swinging between being constipated and having diarrhea. Made it difficult to go out anywhere because you're constantly thinking, I need the toilet in a minute. But I put it down the piles, as you do. So I was doing that, and I had other things on my head, going around in my head at the time. So I've never really done much about it. But yeah, I did kind of think, you know, you read up on it, symptoms of various things, and you think, it's that. At the moment, now, I mean, things have got steadily worse in a way, I guess. You still have to be aware when you go to the toilet. You have to be aware when you fall, in case you follow through, and either shit yourself or spray out blood. And at the moment, I get a lot of pain in the groin area on my stomach. My stomach's bloated, even though I'm losing weight. That's one of the things they ask you at hospital. Are you losing weight? Because that's a big thing with cancer that I've known about, or I know, is people with cancer lose weight. They go pretty thin. Weight lost. A lot of weight, I've lost a few pounds, it fluctuates probably a couple of pounds a day. Yesterday I was the same weight as I was today, and I ate quite a bit yesterday. Your appetite does tend to go though, not eat so much. So yeah, my stomach does really hurt at times, agonising hurt. So I do a lot of drink. Which pretty often I said I shouldn't be doing. Shit, you've got to have some pleasures in life, haven't you? So what I've found is if I have a drink, not excessive amount, not like I used to, but I have a nice two or three glasses, maybe four. And when I go to bed, if I'm a bit uncomfortable, after a while I've found a cocodamol tablet works wonders. After a while you just go poof out of the light. It's like a sleeping tablet. It's probably mixed with the alcohol, don't do any good. But yeah, I found that really knocks you out for a few hours. The only trouble is, it makes me sweat. And you wake up in a pool of sweat. So that's one to keep at the back of my mind if things do get a bit too much. A few drops of whiskey and a few cocodamol go into the nice sleep and don't wake up. Can't think of a better way to go. So anyway, that's it for the moment. Update 6, as I say. 24th of this month, which isn't that far away, but we know 13th. 10 days, 10, 11 days, and then get this wee bastard out and see what's up with the bladder. Right, that's it. See ya. Maybe. Have a good day.